This is Sarah. Sarah is an older adult who suffers from mobility impairment, limiting her ability to get around easily. This leaves her homebound, socially isolated, and unable to work, causing serious financial strain. For these reasons, Sarah is 2 to 3 times more likely to experience depressive symptoms than someone without mobility impairment. To treat these symptoms, typical treatments involve antidepressant medication and/or clinic-based psychotherapy. For older adults like Sarah, antidepressants show limited effects as they don't develop a framework against the daily stresses faced by older adults. Psychotherapy is especially important for Sarah to help her cope with her disability and low income. However, accessing clinic-based depression treatment can be very difficult due to Sarah's homebound status, low income, and lack of transportation. Other systemic access barriers can also prevent Sarah receiving treatment. These include scheduling difficulties around existing primary care commitments, a shortage of licensed psychotherapists for older patients, and high copay burden. For other patients, personal barriers or preferences can also prevent treatment access. These include the perceived stigma around mental health, a denial of depression, a lack of motivation, and a reliance on religion. Therefore, facilitating access to psychotherapies for low-income, homebound, older adult patients, such as Sarah, is vital. But how do you overcome these access barriers? Dr. Namkee Choi at the University of Texas has been investigating this. Her research is focused on technology, using video conferencing to administer behavioral therapies, increase access, and improve outcomes. Her program uses problem-solving therapy, or PST, a short-term treatment based on the theory that people with problem-solving difficulties also have difficulties dealing with stress, leading to depression. Dr. Choi compared the effect of home-based tele-PST against both in-person PST and depression support telephone care calls. She found that, after patients overcame their initial reservations, using home-based tele-PST was most effective at lowering depressive symptoms over both the short and long term. Therapists reported this was because older patients were less distracted than during in-person PST or care calls and could master a new technology whilst comfortable at home. Dr. Choi hopes tele-PST will become more widely adopted, although a shortage of licensed mental health clinicians remains a barrier. Currently, Dr. Choi is testing another tele-delivered depression treatment, behavioral activation, delivered by trained lay providers. Preliminary results show this model is also effective. Delivering depression therapy through video conferencing offers an exciting avenue for further research. Through Dr. Choi's work, depressive symptoms suffered by underserved population groups, like Sarah's, could soon be a thing of the past.